Good morning, everybody. How many are brand new to WordPress? How many built one or two sites? How many do this for a living, build sites for a living? Raise your hands up high, because everybody in this room is going to want to meet you. Great. Well, I appreciate you all, everybody coming to my presentation. I hope we'll get it all kicked off. Have any of you had this kind of a feeling? Show of hands. Come on, who's lying? All right. You download the presentation from my website. I'll have this back up at the last slide, so you don't want it to copy down right now if you like it. So my intention today is take you on a what I call my foreign journey as a mere mortal on building a website. Anybody here feel like a mere mortal? Not too technical? Raise your hands. Okay. All right. We're on the same page. So what I want to do is kind of give you some planning tips for your trip into building your website. Does that sound good?
Yes.
Well, you know, sometimes you just need to get away. It's been really hot, so I thought I'd bring a picture of Rochester, New York. When I'm trying to go down to the work camp down in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, I put my garage door up and had 12 inches of snow I had to deal with. So, needless to say, delay our trip a little bit. But anyways, my idea is that for those of us that are new to websites and WordPress, it's almost like, you know, you're going to go away, you're going on a new journey. So the first thing you need to decide is, what kind of traveler are you? Are you an adventurer? It's the journey that excites you. Maybe you're budget-minded. Do you like to make detailed plans for yourself? You know, you're going to go to the websites like Travelocity, kind of plan your trip, you know, make all your arrangements for your hotel and everything, and you're going to do it all yourself. Maybe you'd like to hire a travel agent, and you're going to book all the sightseeing trips and your hotel and your flights and whatnot for you, but you're going to go on your trip by yourself or with a friend. Or maybe you like your type of traveler likes an all-inclusive tour. You know what? I want to sit back and enjoy the scenes. Can everybody relate to traveling like this? How many people traveled to come to this meeting? Who traveled the farthest? Take a guess. Anybody? Who thinks they traveled the farthest?
You.
No, I'm where'd you come from?
Newark, New Jersey. 4 hours.
I got your beat. Okay. That was 6 hours. So, if you can all relate to different types of travelers, it may also relate to what kind of developer you should be. Are you an adventurer? Do you want to learn as you go? Are you budget-minded? Are you a detailed planner? You know, sure, WordPress is easy if you plan for it correctly. You want to hire a developer to set up your site, and then you're going to just add content and maintain it. Or do you want to completely outsource it? Just make me rank number one on Google. See the comparisons and how we can relate to this? So, my real job is not web design. I'm not a geek. My wife and I run a business called True Creations. My last name, Echter, means true or genuine in German. So I'm a wood turner.
Yay.
I spin wood. Who is I heard a yay? All right. I've been spinning wood for 40 years. Into architectural journey. I have a whole product line of tools that I make for spinners, people who make yarn. My last presentation, I had a woman sitting there knitting away, so she related to what I do. And now they run a wood turning school. My wife has a long arm quilting business. Her sewing machine is 14 feet long, all fully computer controlled. It's not for your average sewer. So these are our primary jobs. But we wanted to, we're kind of adventuresome. We thought we'd kind of figure it out. We're very budget-minded. And besides, everybody says WordPress. It's easy, right? So, when you go on a travel, of course, you need to take your suitcase and pack for your trip. You start to think about your planning. We needed to define the itinerary for our goals, for our site. So our primary thing was we wanted to replace our old Yahoo site. We built a site probably 8-9 years ago. It's still operational. It still drives traffic. And it's very dated looking. But it was clean. It was built with something called Yahoo Site Builder. And it got the job done. But it was an absolute bear to maintain. As far as goals for our trip, my wife really wanted the ability to edit. She wanted to make some changes to the website, and she gave them to me, and 6 weeks later, I maybe would, make the spelling correction. So she wanted the ability to edit herself. I wanted to put up an e-commerce store, and we wanted a system that was just easier to maintain. So these were the goals for our trip. So, the first thing you have to do when you go on a trip is you got to get your tickets out. So you got to have your tickets, your passport, all that stuff. So, what were our tickets? Well, I started, where many of you are today, at my first WordCamp in Buffalo 2014. My wife had found out about this thing called WordPress. She'd gone to a local meetup meeting. And she goes, oh, there's this WordCamp in Buffalo next weekend. You got to go. And I'm like, what's WordPress? She's like, well, it's a web development environment. You got to go to that. All right, I'll go. You knew nothing about it. Well, I went and spent my $20. I came home. I said, that's the best $20 I've ever spent in my life. I got breakfast. I got lunch. I got dinner. I got a t-shirt, and I got to sit through six very interesting presentations, and I think we can do this. So, we went out to Barnes & Noble's, I went to the library, got some books. Now, in Rochester, New York, we've got a really pretty active meetup group and Facebook group. I'm assuming that you have it here in Boston also. I don't know, can anybody verify that? Day and age? Okay. I mean, our Facebook group, you can post a question to it 7x24 and you'll have an answer within a couple of minutes. Somebody's always on it. I started looking at YouTube videos. I'm a visual learner. That's just the way I like to learn. Now, Google's my friend. When I finally figured out what this thing called Codex was, I didn't know what's a Codex. What's the manual for WordPress? It's a term that I hadn't heard before. Well, if I had a question, I just Googled it and typically I'd get an answer. And we adapted a process of learn, implement, and improve. That's really what we wanted to do for our go-forward basis. So this was our ticket into the world of WordPress and development of website. So some of the you know, it's like going to a foreign country, just a different language. And you have to go to WordPress meetings, and you have to go to WordCamps, and you got to read, and you got to look at, you know, YouTube videos, and then all of a sudden it starts to make sense. You start to understand it. So there's this thing called WordPress.org and WordPress.com. And you hear things like self-hosting and whatever. What does all of this stuff mean? Well, in a real simple manner, WordPress.com is if you're going to put up a little one or two page website or have a little simple blog, you can just go to WordPress.com. You know, it's not fancy, you know, it's got limited theme support, there's no plugins, you aren't going to do e-commerce on it or anything like that. But you know what, you can put up a real simple blog or a little simple shop or, you know, website, you know, for, you know, it's all taken care of. WordPress.org is, you know, that's where if I wanted to put up a store, you wanted to pick a different theme, you wanted to use these different plugins, you know, that's where you really control and maintain your own website. Terminology that you have to get familiar with, WordPress.org, WordPress.com. The next thing area that we had to grow up with was, you know, we started hearing things like CSS, CMS, and all these. What are all these acronyms? Well, CSS stands for Cascading Style Sheets. And it's really, it just describes how HTML elements are displayed in a web browser, and on screen and on paper and whatnot. It saves you a lot of work. And all your external style sheets and whatnot are stored in CSS files. On the bottom right, you'll see w3schools.com. Take a note, that's a place where you can start to learn stuff. w3schools.com. So here's the same information displayed two different manners in the CSS. Right? So you got headers, they get different colors, they got different menu structures and whatever, all the same information. Okay? So that's a basic look, feel of a website. Make sense? People can understand it. So, how many people have not seen the WordPress dashboard? People, I mean, you're really brand new. You'll see this throughout the day, different presentations. But this is your basic, you know, when you first enter into and log into your site, your first dashboard. You know, you got the menu system on the side, you know, it shows you, you know, what posts you have, what pages you have, what theme you're using. Here I got WooCommerce, I got products. I got some tools, I got some settings, I got some SEO, you know, work going on. You know, I got, it's telling me I've sold something here the other day. You know, I've got people who are coming in, coming out. There's events coming on. You know, I took this screenshot a little while ago. You know, WordCamp Austin would have been on here if I took it more recently. Tells you, you know what, I've been slacking on my maintenance. I should have been doing this. I've got five new updates that I have to do to the system. So that's just what the basic menu. I'm not going to give you a demo on it or anything like that. I just want to at least kind of show it to you. How many people are interested in doing e-commerce? How many people have heard of WooCommerce? Okay. Kind of the main e-commerce platform. This is the WooCommerce screen. See, you've got, you know, I got photos of each image that I sell. I've got, you know, the title of the page, whether it's in stock, what the price is, what kind of categories I've listed it under, the tags. And there's even, you know, some red lights, yellow lights about SEO. I don't worry that much about SEO on my e-commerce site because the products change on a regular basis. But anyways, that's what a basic WooCommerce screen looks like. So as you go on your trip, to, they get it in your hotel and whatnot, you're going to start to unpack your clothes. And that's the theme, you know, so you got to get your swag out, you know, here's my Fort Camp Buffalo shirt. And it's really, the themes are your site's appearance. You know, think about, you know, do I want a casual looking site, do I want a fancy looking site, you know, whatever. So themes you get from WordPress.org, that's the repository. There are free themes, you'll hear terms like 2015, you know, 2016, 2017. So every time you bring up a WordPress environment, you have to have at least one theme. If you don't have a theme, you can't see anything. Right? Now, so it basically shifts with the theme. You know, guess what? In 2015, they shipped it with the 2015 theme. Made sense? They said, you know, et cetera, et cetera. So now I can overlay it with a different theme. I can go to the repository and go find a theme, or I can go buy a theme and overlay it. So if I put in a secondary theme, it's still oftentimes good to leave one other free theme on your site so that if there's a problem or whatever, you can at least revert to the simple theme and bring it up to your content. So the themes are really what the look and feel of your site. Now, as you travel, you know, you got to get your guidebooks and whatnot. Anybody ever gone to AAA and got a tour book? All right. If you're going on a trip with a tour guide, I had to find some tour guides to take us on our journey with WordPress. So I had the bright idea that the very, you know, my first entry into WordPress, I was going to put up an e-commerce store. If I had to do it again, I probably would have done it in a second, but I didn't know any better. So I was poking around on YouTube, and I found this guy, Josh Jackson, calls the WPSculptor.com, and he had a YouTube video up to create an e-commerce website. And I looked at it, well, that looks kind of cool. He uses something called a My Style theme. So I put up my e-commerce site, tcspindles.com. His video is about, I don't know, it was 3 hours long or something like that. And I sat at the kitchen table, I fired up my Roku, YouTube, and in one weekend I just basically go do this, stop, and then did that. And then after, you know, 2 days, I had a fully functional e-commerce site up and running. Didn't fully understand it. It was still all kind of like mud to me. But it was up and running, and I could sell stuff. My wife, she found this woman, Katrina. She's got several YouTube videos up on YouTube. So she put up TC Quilting, and then I used it as a guide to put up TC Turning using the Virtue theme. And it's the same thing. I mean, we just sat there and just kind of like watched the video. They were our tour guides and got us right along into building our first initial sites. Then we found Corey Ashton. Now, Corey's actually going to be, she's here work camp, and she's speaking tomorrow. She's from San Antonio, Texas. She's very shy and bashful. But she has these over 200 videos that are, you know, I don't know, 3 to 5 minutes long. And they're right to the point, boom, you know, here's how to go do this, boom, boom. Now, she just launched within the last week or two, Ask Corey. So it's AskCorey.com, and she's got her videos all up there now. And a wonderful resource. My wife is building a whole new site. She goes, you know, I couldn't have done it without Corey. And she's just thrilled to have the opportunity to go meet her. And, you know, she has old things like Gravity Forms, Divi, and topic. She's got it in there. It's just short, sweet, to the point, no screwing around. And, great tour guide. So once you get to your room and whatnot, of course, you've got to start to continue unpacking, you know, you get your dock kit out, things like that, your trip. So I treat my plugins and tools as my dock kit. So plugins are these things that add functionality. And specific set of features for the WordPress site. Again, WordPress.org is the repository. And there are paid plugins. And then there are tools. And Jetpack, they're one of our major sponsors for this WordCamp. You know, they have, it's a plugin. It used to be a bunch of little different plugins. It's all been combined. And it just has all sorts of little tools on it to collect names, locate things on your site. It's just it's a point box. Automatic, they're the company that builds Jetpack, but they're also the people behind WordPress.com. So you'll start hearing this mainly automatic. So as we traveled, of course, language barriers was our biggest challenge. Just all new terminology. Any of you starting to experience that? Admit it. All right.
Oh yeah.
Just the simple things. Basic page layout. What's a menu bar? What's a sidebar, header, footer? What's an image slider? What's an image gallery? It's like, okay, I've been to websites and they got these pictures going by. What's that called? I don't know what I want. I didn't know how to describe it. Oh, that's an image slider. Oh, okay, that makes sense. I need to have a whole bunch of pictures. Oh, that's a gallery. You just have to come up to speed. There's forms and things like that. So. These are just basic terminologies that you're going to have to get used to. Some tripping and stumbling block points. Media is by far, I think WordPress is actually pretty easy. It's the taking the photographs and editing the photographs and figuring out your PDFs and your videos and things like that. That's a challenge. So you have this thing called a media library, and I make these things called drop spindles, which are, you can just put a twist in fiber to make yarn. So I make hundreds of these things. I got a photograph of every one of those, I got documents, I got articles I've written for returning journals and things like that. All my media goes there. And so that's kind of like, here's your media, here's the library, add new, all right? So I just found that was a tripping and stumbling point for us. So when you're traveling, of course, you need to get, your maps out. We're going to go get information. The nice thing is it's just a ton of resources available. WordPress.org, WordPress TV, Google, of course, YouTube, books, local meetup groups, and WordCamp. There's just a... This is a whole community. One of the things that's been... My wife and I were talking about this as we drove over here. The whole concept of open source software was very foreign to me. I used to sell software for anywhere between $2 and $6 million a license years ago. To go get open source software was just a concept that I was having a real tough time getting my head around. And then, we go to these meetings one day and we just found and met a very diverse group of people, all had a common interest. and everybody was very helpful, and you could ask anybody a question, and if they didn't know how to answer it, to go find somebody who could help you answer it. I mean, it was just like, this is just a nice community. And, you know, the reason I give this talk is, you know, as a non-technical person, I want to be able to give back to the community. And so, you know, when you're at these events, think that, you know, this would not be available without, you know, the sponsors downstairs. You know, so go visit them. They're throwing in, you know, thousands of dollars towards this thing to make this event happen. You know, check them out. You know, go to the after party. Sit down at lunch and talk to, you know, sit down to people you've never met before and just talk to them. Find them. Who's a beginner? Who's an expert? Who's in their meeting? And start to build your network, because then you can take it, you know, we literally have built all our sites and whatnot for the cost of free. And we you know, yeah, we bought some add-ons and things like that, but I mean, you know, essentially it has cost us very little money to put up three, now almost four sites. And, you know, you can do that because you get to meet people and say, I'm hitting a wall on something, you know, I can call this person. Oh yeah, here's how you do it. Great. I mean, that's what's wonderful. So get involved, network, go to the after party. You know, if you're worth thinking of going, go. Go to the after party, just meet people. So, all right, you're going to this WordPress journey. You gotta book a hotel. You gotta figure out, you know, how am I going to put this site up? Well, the first thing you have to do is register your domain name. There are companies that do this. You know, some of your hosting companies can do it for you. And then, you know, there are what we call the self-hosting companies. And there's fees associated. I mean, you know, they run data centers and whatnot, and they're going to put up an environment for you, and you got to pay them rent. It might be $10 a month, it might be $2 a month, it might be $20 a month, depending on your situation. So, well, several of the vendors downstairs are here. I mean, Bluehost, Pantheon, Pressable, A2 Hosting, DreamHost, SiteGround, GoDaddy, they're all sponsors, they're all downstairs. Go talk to them, you know, hear their pitch, and then you can make a decision as to where you want to host your website. So yeah, WordPress is free, a free tool, but yeah, you gotta host it. You may have to pay some tools, you know, for some tools and add-ons and things like that. So now, I want to go into, I'm traveling on my trip, and I gotta do some currency exchange, right? Anybody interested in currency exchange on their website? Like, money coming to you? Anybody interested? Okay. So, the big guy is WooCommerce. Have you heard of WooCommerce? They're your sponsor of this event. They're downstairs, I believe, also. I believe they have a sponsor. There's another one called Equid. Now, primary difference. WooCommerce, you own it. It's on your site. It's on your environment. If any of you have gone to a site where you're trying to, USPS as an example, Postal Service, if you're trying to order a priority mail box or whatever, and you want to pay with PayPal, it sends you out to PayPal and then brings you back. Right? Equid does that in an e-commerce environment. So if somebody wants to buy, look at something on your storefront, it's going to go out to the Equid site and then come back. But they're going to take care of all the maintenance and hosting and all that. WooCommerce, you're going to take care of it all. Now, downstairs, there's some partners here. Jilt is one. They do things like, you know, they'll work with WooCommerce and with WordPress. The Jilt will do things like follow-up emails. So if somebody comes to your site, they log out, you know, it will send them a thank you email, it will do a, your card is empty email, things like that. So if you're interested in an e-commerce environment, look up, you know, talk to the Jilt people. Follow-up pay, you've heard of Omnibus, heard of PayPal, you've heard of Stripe, have you heard of Stripe? Yes, no? Wait, not heard of Stripe? And Stripe is becoming a very popular credit card processing service. Liquid Lens got some add-on information also. So the biggest challenge I found with putting up the storefront is image editing, and it just takes a lot of time. Now, just because you have a camera that can take an 18 gigabyte image doesn't mean you should use an 18 gigabyte image on your website. We had an instance in Rochester 6 months ago. Somebody redid their site. You know, they hired an expert to redo their site. Their front page was taking over 12 minutes to load because they were using 18 gigabyte images. Images now in WooCommerce land, your image only needs to be 500 by 500 DPI. It's 72 DPI. It's a pretty small image. Yeah. A photo tent? Okay, a photo tent is like a pop-up tent. It's a cube, white. It's got photo lights for CLL, light bulbs. And all it does is give you a filtered light so there's no hot spots. So you put your object, you know, if you're a jewelry maker or whatever, you put your object inside of the tent. Take a picture of it, and it gives you nice diffused lighting. And you know, I got mine at Harbor Freight years ago. I don't know if they still sell it, but you know, it's literally a pop-up wire cube with fabric on 5 and 6 sides. And I just got some chop lights. So I use GIMP as my photo editing. Again, I'm on the budget of free, so I didn't want to pay a lot of money for Photoshop. I use GIMP, and it's I use about 0.5% of its functionality because I'm basically all I'm doing is cropping images with it. And then I use I make drop spindles. So I might go make 30 drop spindles, and I sit there and I take 30 to 40 pictures. Because sometimes I'll take about a picture at the bottom. So I have 30 to 40 images to edit. So I go and use GIMP and I'll take and crop them all. So I put them into a directory of originals. And then I go create another directory where I cropped them. And then I create another directory and I run them through Fast Home Capture. And what that allows me to do is take all of them, click on them, and I say I want to convert these to 72 DPI, 500 by 500 in a PNG format, and it does it like that. So, very, very nice tool. And then there's a little add-on you can put onto Google. It's called Color Zone. It's just a little picking pen, so if you're poking around the web and you see something that looks interesting, a nice color, you can pick on it, and it will give you the information. So as you travel, I always like to keep a journal. And I've done this from the very first WordCamp I went to. So I've got every meeting I've gone to, I've got a journal, I've got notes. Because as you go to meetings and you start talking to people, you will pick things up. Oh, that's an interesting plugin. Oh, that's a nice theme. Oh, that's nice add-on. Oh, they doesn't work so good. Or this person's an expert. Whatever. And I just keep a theme, a journal. So keep notes for meetings, tips. We had somebody discover, if you put a YouTube video on, if you ever been to a site where you clicked on a YouTube video, and it gets all done, it then brings up all the competitors' videos. Have you ever seen that? Have you ever seen that? Yeah. You don't want that, right? Well, there's more codes, more characters that you put at the end of the YouTube video, and it will stop it. Well, good tip. I watch that down. I can't remember what it was. I had to go search for it, but every time I put a YouTube video up, I use that. So, good plugins, your corporate standards, your, you know, whatever, logins, vendors, renewal dates. I mean, just how you did something, just keep it there. Now, safety tips for your journey. You're going to hear something called a child date. So, remember early on, I talked a little bit about CSS. So, you put up your WordPress environment, you pick the theme, you start coding it, you start building your site, and you say, you know what, I don't like the color of that button. And there's no way of editing it through, you know, through the theme. So, you go to a meeting and you ask somebody, you know, some expert that you met at lunch, how do I edit this? And they call up some tool, they look at it, so here's the line of code, change this, boom, boom, boom. And they changed your button from blue to green. Great, you're happy. The problem is, if you do an upgrade to the next version of your of WordPress or your theme, those edits get wiped out. And now you're going to find the person again. So you create what they call a child theme. You got the parent theme, so that's your environment. You create a child theme, and you do all your edits in the child theme. And that way they're maintained. So anytime you do an upgrade to WordPress, an upgrade to your theme, an upgrade to your plugin or whatever, those things are maintained. You don't lose them. So you always want to do any kind of customization in a child theme environment. If you walk away from knowing one thing from this presentation, child theme is it. Okay? Backup, backup, backup. So one of the first plugins you're going to put in is a backup tool. And before, you know, anytime you're going to do any kind of updates or changes, major changes to your environment, to your site, back it up. It may take 10 minutes, 20 minutes, depending on how big your site is, make a backup. You do your upgrades, you know, I showed you in the menu that I had 5 updates to be done. I would have made a backup. I would have implemented 1 to 5 of the updates. Check my site if it's all working, and make another backup, and then let it go. Put in your anti-malware, security, and brute force tools. They're downstairs. We've got WordFence, SiteLock, Traitware. They're all, you know, they all play in this space. Go spend some time with them. And I can never pronounce their story. That ask you that. Whatever, that's in a spam elevator. So, as you get in this journey, you want to go sightseeing. And it's really a community, and you need to get involved with it. So, as you travel, you need to take pictures. I'm going to take a picture of my audience here. Everybody wave. Very good. All right. Because we're on your journey, right? So, you know, go sightseeing. Join your Facebook, local Facebook meetup groups. We have, once a month or so, we try to do co-working days. Great way to, you know, a lot of us are independent, you know. It's nice to get out of your shops, out of your studios, and be around other human beings. Take some classes. Go to work camps. Have fun. Meet new people. Okay? But the theme is get involved. I mean, if you asked me 4 years ago when I'd be speaking at WordPress conference, you know, WordCamp, what's WordCamp? You know, I've spoken to four of these things. I mean, it's just get involved. So, I wish you all a wonderful trip. I thank you for the giving me the privilege of your time, and I hope this was of some interest to you. And are there feedback forms or anything like that? Don't pay attention. Tom? Not pay attention. I think you may get a survey or whatever. Provide feedback, let us help us improve our presentation. And if you're Thank you. Have any questions that I can answer in my non-deep manner? Hopefully this was helpful, and have a wonderful trip.